week on American Air Gunner, it's time for some DIY. Today, we're building a pellet trap. Jim Chapman is with us, and he's hunting some exotic game all the way from Africa. Rick Usler is with us, and of course, we'll be at the round table. All this and more coming up right now on American Air Gunner. Hey, welcome to this week's round table. This week I'm joined by my man here, Jim Chapman, Rick Usler, and of course our resident hunter who's here all the time, Steve Kreiner. We love having him here on set and out of the woods. So today we're going to talk calibers, but I want to talk calibers for predators and large game. First of all, I want to go to you with this, Jim. When we talk predators and large game, what kind of animals are we talking about?
Well, I mean, predators, it's normally coyote, fox, bobcat. You can include raccoon in there. As a matter of fact, it's funny. Raccoon will come at a call faster and more aggressively than just about anything. That's what we're typically talking about. You could also group bear and mountain lion in there.
Talking about big game hunting, what states can you even do it in as of now?
Yeah, Arizona was just this year.
They passed right it.
Missouri 3 years ago, I believe?
Missouri is three or four years ago they allowed it. Virginia allows you to hunt deer with an air gun. Actually, big game.
And turkeys also.
Alabama?
Alabama just this year. Went down and did a hunt there earlier in the year, first year for hunting deer.
Okay, so it's a few states.
A lot of states you can hunt wild hog.
Okay.
You know, so you can shoot ferals with an air gun. And you put those together, there's actually a growing opportunity for hunters.
So once you're out there, predatorial or big game, we're talking calibers. I'm assuming we're ranging in this. We've seen our small calibers here up to, what is a 30 or 303. Are we starting with big game at 357?
I think a 357 is a good starting place.
Yeah, it's a great caliber for predators, and that's mainly what I hunt. It's a good all-around caliber for predator. When you slip up to big game, Missouri, I believe it's legal, 40 caliber.
40
and
caliber.
You know, I would probably pick a 40 or 45 caliber over a 50 caliber.
The big advantage with 357, it's flat shooting and it carries the power. It gives you all the attributes.
How many different types of guns on the market in the 357 caliber?
There's quite a few.
Really?
I mean, that's a really good, very attractive caliber. That's probably my preferred big bore.
In America right now, where we can go and hunt big game, you've got to use something 40 caliber or above, correct?
Well, it depends on the state. Missouri.
Okay, so let's just take 357 off the table for a second. So we've got that. So now we're dealing with obviously now 45s here, 45, 50 caliber, and then we've got a 58 here. So we've got a 200 grain, 300, 425, and then this is like 490, 495, right around 500. And obviously, that's a big change in the size of the projectile. How much is that going to change your shot and what you can take down with this?
Here's the difference. When you're using a powder burner, the energy is stored within the cartridge, the bullet. So you can hand load, you can change the loads behind it to drive. So if you go to a heavier bullet, you ramp up the powder charge. Yeah. With an air gun, usually you can't adjust the power.
You got what you got.
What about like a ball? Just to
find out what your gun likes.
Yeah, that's it.
Because I had the Recluse, and I found that it shot the round ball the best for me. Mm-hmm. And at 50 yards, I had three shots touching.
Really?
And that gun's phenomenal. It's a machine.
I've also shot the Recluse and also the Dragon Claw with round ball, and they're dead accurate.
I shot the Whitetail with the round ball and the Coyote this year on video with the 105 grain round.
So you guys you're changing, you're making differences. You're sometimes using a round nose, you're sometimes using the round ball. Tell these people when to make the difference. When do you use what?
Find out what you're gonna.
Yeah, that's what it comes down to. Whatever shoots best. Yeah.
I really like the EvenX Rainstorm and the EvenX Sniper. They have the same action in 357. I shoot the JSB pellets through those. It has everything you need for mid-size game predators and small antelope. It's great. Flat shooting, it gives good penetration, good terminal effect.
Let's keep budget in mind.
Yeah.
You know, if you don't want to go out and spend $1,200, $1,500, $1,000, Sam Yang Recluse.
Yep.
It's a $699 price point.
That's really,
Pyramid Air.
That's
you go, you buy it.
Listen, if you want more information, obviously there's a lot of information about big bore guns. Get on our website, AmericanAirGunner.com. We'll have information and links to all these guys' websites and blogs and stuff that they write, so you can find out. Trust me, all the information you'd ever want on a big bore gun. More coming up on American Air Gunner right after this.
Don't go away, because there's plenty more American Air Gunner coming up right after this. American Air Gunner is sponsored by Umarex, zeroed in. By Pyramid Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns. And by Hotsign, serious, solid impact.
The pistols you've watched in action for generations and the ones you've always wanted to own are now within your reach. Introducing Boomer X Action Pistols. These high-quality replica pistols, powered by CO2, look, shoot, and feel just like a powder burner. Plus, ammo is economical and always available. Boomer X Action Pistols. From the past, present, and shooting into the future.
The Boomer X Octane features tremendous velocity with a quiet downrange noise thanks to the integrated Silence Air noise dampening system. Powered by the Reaxis gas piston that provides more punch, more power, and more speed. These two technologies combined deliver a smooth, accurate shot with maximum power. The Boomer X Octane.
PyramidAir.com. Let's see. That was fast. Bingo.
Honey, did you do those chores yet?
Chores?
Lawn.
Roger, put that drink down. We gotta mow. Chop, chop.
Oh, yeah. He's out there showing the grass he's boss.
Pyramid Air. Big selection, fast shipping, the air gun experts.
All right, so we're back here at Airgun Web with Rick Usser doing a little gun review. And, you know, again, this is one of my favorite places in the world. It's an air gunner's paradise. Today we're reviewing some pistols, looking at a few Berettas here. I'm seeing an 84, 92, obviously the Beretta in a airsoft and air gun. Let's talk about them. Why do you love Berettas?
I like guns. Are you kidding me? The name on the outside can be somewhat irrelevant. I love shooting. That's why I do this.
Okay, let's talk about the 84 first. In the airsoft and the air gun, what are the differences, if any?
The only difference is the ammo it shoots.
Okay.
It's basically it. If you prefer shooting airsoft, it's maybe a little safer for that new shooter, a little training for youngsters or whatnot. First of all, there's a few things I really, really like about this gun. The weight and feel is phenomenal. Go ahead and pick that one up. I mean, you'll feel it. It's got just such a good feel to it.
It does.
Very, very good.
So great for training purposes.
Right. There's an actual firearm counterpart to this gun. So okay. If this was the model that they had as a carry, then buying something like this for training is ideal.
Okay.
And we're indoors, and I have a safe way to trap the ammunition or the projectiles.
Sure.
So shooting indoors, it's relatively quiet. You don't have to travel. It's just a really safe way to maintain that proficiency, which is critical if you're going to carry. Are you going to have a firearm? You got to know how to use it. First thing we'll do is we're going to go ahead and put our CO2 in. What I really like about the way they've done this is that they've used a completely removable magazine that has both the ammo and the CO2 in it. Why is this important? If there were to be a leak, you're replacing the magazine. You can always buy another magazine and you don't lose the gun. Okay. The other cool thing is as you rapid fire, CO2 is going to get colder and colder and you're going to have less velocity in your shot. So if you have several magazines, it's very great for training because you drop one mag, drop in another one, and now you're back up and running.
Okay.
And you maintain that high velocity. So we'll grab our CO2.
Okay.
We'll go ahead and drop that in place. That's it. So what you're going to do to load this is you're going to pull down on this and push it over.
Mm-hmm.
And now this stays locked into place. You just drop your BBs in. Then when you release it, it'll keep them tight at the top and it'll just shoot them out as fast as you can pull the trigger.
Pop them in and you're good to go.
Now here's what I like about this gun. Now this is empty. Okay.
Yep.
Listen to the rapport. It's one of the nicest sounding and feeling CO2 guns. When this discharges, boy, it feels nice. And the airsoft is just as fun.
So you can get the 84 for, you can get these for less than $100.
Yeah, those are right around $100.
Okay, and so let's move it up. If you really want to step it up a notch, a little bit bigger, a little more accurate, more powerful gun, let's talk about the 92.
Right, now this is going to be very different. This doesn't have the blowback. As you notice when I pull the trigger, the slide moves. This doesn't have the blowback, but I want you to feel the weight of that gun.
Wow.
And all the details are extremely real. And the way you're going to operate this gun is you've got CO2, which is stored in here.
Okay.
Okay. And we'll put that back. All right, so there's a little lever here. We'll do it this way. And that slides open.
Okay, got a little round mag, eight pellets.
There you go. So you put your eight pellets. Now that's different than the other ones we're looking at because this shoots pellets. Mm-hmm. A little heavier, a little more accurate, a little more energy.
So depending on what you're looking for, we got the 84 here in the airsoft and the air gun with the rapport. It's got a nice little pop, feels real. Then of course the 92 in the Beretta. A lot of great pistols from Beretta. Check them out on AmericanAirGunner.com and you can probably find them at most of your local retail stores. Am I
Absolutely.
Right? Absolutely. All right, appreciate it. We're gonna go out and shoot these and have a little fun with air guns.
I'm gonna grab this one.
Let's go. We come back, it's Woodshop 101. We're making pellet traps. All right, it's time for our American Air Gunner Trivia, brought to you this year by our friends at Blue Book Publications.
Quiet Energy, a new line of PCP air guns from Hotsun USA. Available in 177, 22, and 25 calibers. The Quiet Energy line of air guns is perfect for serious target practice as well as small to medium-sized game hunting. The new Quiet Energy series delivers more usable shots per fill and puts more energy downrange while keeping the noise levels to minimum. If you're looking for power and accuracy in a quiet air gun, your search is over with the Quiet Energy line of PCP air guns from Hotsun USA. Life can be loud, but sometimes silence is golden. Introducing the Umarex Fusion Air Rifle with a combination of CO2 power, the Silence Air 5 chamber noise dampener, and a precision rifled barrel. The Fusion is a bona fide tech driver that's the quietest air rifle you'll ever own. Experience silence with the Umarex Fusion at umarexusa.com/FusionTV.
Today on American Air Gunners DIY, we're making pellet traps. Not as hard as you may think. You just need a little bit of wood, some wood screws, some steel, and a little bit of know-how, which we're gonna help you with. Off to the hardware store. All right, first thing we need to get some screws. Could use nails, but then if you do, you have to use wood glue to keep everything together, and that just gets messy. So we're gonna go with wood screws, and make sure they're wood screws. Don't get drywall screws, deck screws, just good old-fashioned wood screws. So we need something to go on the back of the pellet trap to stop the pellets. It's gotta be steel, gotta be hard, gotta be tough. This looks like it. This is aluminum. Super flimsy. We want steel. See that? Nothing's going through that. All right, so now you need like a compound to go in front of the steel trap to block the pellets, keep them from going through. Go to your electrical department, try to find this. It's a duct seal compound. It's squishy, kind of like a Play-Doh or something like that. It's great, it absorbs the pellets and makes your trap even stronger. Something to hold your targets. A clipboard just like this with a little bit of modification, works perfect. All right, so we're back from the hardware store. We got all our supplies. Now we just need to get some tools and get started. And I do love a good DIY project. All right, so here's what we're making today. It is a silent pellet trap. It's made out of wood. It's got a steel back, as you can see here. And then there's the clipboard, hold your target. On the inside is our duct seal we put to make it silent. This is what we're making. We're gonna make ours out of 2x4. I've already cut it was a 2x4x8. I've cut it down just so it's manageable. Got my clipboard right here to hold the targets. We're gonna end up cutting this out with a jigsaw. We'll show you how to do that later. Got our steel backing and of course our duct seal. So first things first, let's cut our wood. So, there we go, we've got our notch for the three sides. Again, guys, listen, woodworking, be careful, be safe, make sure you have supervision. If you don't know what you're doing, don't try this. All right, there you go. So I only need 8.5 inches, so I've got this about a foot. So when we cut it, we just cut our 8.5 inches and we are good to go. I like to use a longer piece just because it's safer. So there you go. We got our box. We got our clipboard. Slides right in. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put four holes in the corners. Now I've got four big holes there, and all I gotta do is get my jigsaw in there and just connect the dots. All right, so there we go. We got our clipboard, got that cut. Now we just gotta get our backing. Now we've got a 22 gauge steel plate. Pretty solid. Now to cut this, you may or may not have the tools. If you don't have the tools to cut a piece of steel like this, you can either build your box to the size of the piece of steel you have, or you could take it to, you know, again, your local hardware store to get it cut to the size you need. So then you want to take your duck seal. I'm not going to open it now, but what you want to do is you'll open it, you'll stick it in there, and you'll just really squeeze it down and make sure you fill the trap in every corner. This should slide right in. And boom! That's how you make a silent pellet trap. If you guys have any more questions, go to AmericanAirGunner.com, do it yourself. Just make sure to be careful when you're making things like this. But let's be honest, the whole point of making a pellet trap is to go shoot guns. So let's go test this puppy out. All right, well, we built it, now we gotta test it. So to test my silent pellet trap, I figured I'd use my Umarex Fusion with Silence Air technology. All right, let's go see how it worked. All right, so as you can see, I put three shots here, just around the bullseye so we can kind of see how it all worked, right?
Yeah, right.
All right, so pull it off and boom, there you go. Three pellets, not even close to the back. As you can see, there's a little bit of target on there, but see, this stuff is gonna harden even more, and it's gonna last me a long, long time. Now, there's another way to go get yourself a silent pellet trap. We have a good one here from UTG, and here's a great one from Air Venturi. But I say, you do it yourself, make it, but most importantly, get out and shoot, just be safe. All right, guys, when we return, Jim Chapman is in Africa, and he's looking for warthogs. Don't go anywhere.
A legend in innovation and tradition. These classical and modern masterpieces have sent pellets downrange for over three decades. German engineered to last a lifetime. Quality, power, precision. RWS, the world's finest air rifles.
Jim Chapman, I'm out in South Africa. We got up real early this morning. We set up down along my friend's farm, down one of the pastures, out after guinea fowl. These things are like turkeys. They're really, really wary. So I've taken my poncho, strung it across a couple trees, give us a blind. We're gonna sit here. I'm guessing probably in the next 10 to 15 minutes as the sun comes up, we're gonna see these birds start to come in across the field. They come rushing in. Guinea fowl are a blast. They look like a huge quail on steroids with polka dots. They move in coveys, and you've got a lot of eyes watching for any movement, so we have to be real careful, get settled in, and wait for them to come. The whole covey's coming right behind us. Hold tight. you see that one standing out there? Yeah. Down. We almost got busted. They walked right behind us, and the blinds opened to the back. Came right along behind that fence line. We sat here. They got out in front of us and got out, and I lined up about 55 yards and took a broadside on one that it hung back. Hit it good. It went running across the field. I saw where it landed over there. We're getting ready to go over and pick him up, and then we looked and we noticed more coming up behind us. We were settling in, but they picked up on some motion and took off. So we'll give it just a couple more minutes, see if anything else comes through, then we'll go collect the down bird over there. Guinea fowl is what got me into air gun shooting in South Africa. I've been coming out here to see family for years and saw guinea fowl all over the place and thought that would be a perfect animal to take with an air gun. My mother-in-law does a wicked stew with them. Well, we waited it out for about, 45 minutes. Sun's coming up, hoping more birds were gonna come in, but unfortunately, nothing else came in. We're gonna go over and collect the bird. It went down on the other side of the fence, and then we'll make one more sweep back around through the bush and see if we get them while they're out there feeding. I was using the 357 because that's the gun I'm gonna be using later today for some bigger game. There he is, right there, other side of the fence. It's a pretty bird. To me, the guinea fowl is the prototypical bird of South Africa. These things are all over the place. It's a great game bird. It's horn over the head. It's a big male. Okay, let's go see what else we can get. We've set up a blind up over a water hole. I'm using a Ranger 45 caliber PCP air rifle. This gun is powerful. It's doing about 600 foot-pound of energy. We sat over the water hole here. Hopefully, warthogs are gonna come in. The weather's a little bit cooler today. The sun's in and out, but they may hold up, but something may come out. I'm gonna sit here for a couple hours, see what happens. Two small warthogs have just come in. They're about the same size. Neither one is really big, but big enough. I'm gonna take the one right on the water. Whoa. You hear that smack? He's down. Let's go take a look. Nice little warthog boar. Again, it's not a big pig. Got a little bit of tusk here. But we decided when you're hunting with air guns, you've limited yourself with range. Hey, Rob. Yeah, just a little guy, but I was just saying as you were walking up, with an air gun, a trophy is the animal you get. I mean,
absolutely. There's opportunity for big pigs, but Africa, sometimes you have to take the opportunity you have on the day. Today it was a bit overcast, it's not ideal for pigs. Yeah. You took the opportunity you had.
Yeah, I mean, you and I have taken bigger pigs with air guns here over the years, but I'm happy with this guy. I had to sit in a cactus patch to get him, so I'm happy to get him. I was looking as I pulled him out, see the exit wound over here, went in. I hit him coming from uphill and came right through and exited over on the left side, left turn, and came out over here. So we had a good cut. He went down hard, just flopped around a couple times and didn't get back up.
Two people have to drag it, not one, huh?
Next week on American Air Gunner, I'm hanging out with Leighton Hart, a new generation air gunner that now shoots competitively, and he'll show us some tips for sighting in your air rifle. We'll be reviewing the Hatsan AT-44, and at the round table, we'll be talking ballistics. And trust me, you do not want to miss this. We'll see you next week.